Yes! Welcome to Financial Paul Channel. And if you are new here, you are lucky. Why? Because you just joined the tribe, a business entrepreneurship tribe. Now on this YouTube channel, Financial Paul Channel, I'm so glad you joined, because on this channel, we give information on business, money, investment, entrepreneurship, all kinds of business. Welcome, and I'm so glad. So now today we want to talk about how you can start your business without capital in 2020 in Nigeria. I could remember when I started my business way back 6 years ago with 3,500 naira, and we grew that business to 7-figure sales, and we leveraged and we enter into e-commerce, we enter into real estate business, and that is what I want to share with you now. I can understand the place where most Nigerians or Africans need to start a business and they don't have capital, they don't have money capital to start a business. Congratulations for joining this YouTube channel, because we're going to explore this. So I want you to wait to the end of the video, because what I want to talk to you on is strong enough to make you a lot of sales and grow your business. So one thing you need to understand as regards starting your business is that sometimes capital, people look at it as money. You don't need only money as your capital. That is why some people will start a business, and when they start a business, just give them a space of 6 months, the money is gone. Why do they have money but the business is nowhere to be found? That's to show that there are other things that you need that can bring in money. And if you have only money, you might not be able to grow that business. And that is what I call intellectual capital, your ability to know the business you want to venture into. What knowledge do you have about that business? You want to go into importation. What do you know about importation? What are the various importation agents? What are the various shipping agents? What are the various client agents? What are the A to Z on importation? You have to know it. Take for instance, you want to start importation and you don't have money. I will show you how you can start that with zero money. Yes, and you make money. So now, you have your intellectual capital, you know the business you want to go to. Take for instance, you want to enter into the fashion business. You know the business you want to go into. If they wake you up in the night, you know that business. You know the in and out of that business. That is intellectual capital. If you have that capital, you know it. You might be asking yourself, I know this business. The next thing you should ask yourself is, do you have other capital? Which is, I'm sharing 5 capitals that you need that will make up your money that you need. So we have social capital. Social capital is the ability to network with people. How good are you talking to people? When you reach out to people, how are you able to foster relationship? How are you able to foster conversation? You need to be able to foster quality conversation with people that you know, these people, they are my prospect, that they can give me money to start my business. So when you reach out to people, you need to tell them, I am an importer. I import this kind of product. This is the amount of profit we make if we import this product. This is that. I'm just using importation as an example. And if you want trainings on importation, click the link below after this video to get access to so many of other trainings that we have free on your mail. And so you tell them, we can do this, we can do that, we can do this. They say, wow, that is good. How do I now come into this? I need this importation guide. How do we do it? You have social capital, you can convince people. If you have intellectual capital, you have social capital, money will follow through. Another capital you need to have is emotional capital. In business, sometimes you might not make sales. Sometimes you might have loss. You need to have emotion to hold it down. That is the ability to, when you have loss in your business or when things are not really going fine, you can laugh with people. You can talk to people. Not that when they see you, you just made a slight setback and you become angry with everybody. You don't want to talk to people, your mood change. If your mood is always changing based on your business mood, if your emotional mood is changing based on your business mood, then that is not a good sign of a quality entrepreneurship skill. You need to have emotional capital. Then going straight into the next few minutes we are up for this video, you now need what we call spiritual capital, which is the God factor. You need a God factor. God can just give you the direction of the kind of product to import, the people you want to talk to, the people you want to reach out to or sell this kind of product. I could remember when we started. Okay, I'm hearing some siren outside. Don't worry about that. When we started, I was led to the product I should sell. I had an idea of this product. This product started coming to my heart. So sometimes you can have it knowing in your heart that, this is the product as you sell. And once you reach out to the people, you discover that they begin to help you out in that line. So you need spiritual capital. Everybody that makes money in this world leverages on the capital, power of God or the power of the devil, but the power of God stands sure. So one of the last thing that you now need, after all this capital, money will follow through. You know your business well, intellectual capital. You know your, you can talk to people well. That is emotion, that is a social capital. You can socialize. You have emotional capital to manage stress, to manage any setback. Then you have the spiritual capital. If you have these four things, money will come out. Money will come out. Another case scenario is still this importation business. I have the knowledge in the importation business, and I have social capital, I have spiritual capital, I have emotional capital. I can just reach out to somebody at the market. Take for instance, Ikeja market, and they are selling something. I say, you see this thing? You can be selling for 50,000 naira. We can bring this in for 25,000 naira. That's just an example related to your own business, whatever you want to kickstart, and you see it's working fine. I am Financial Paul. I'm glad you joined us on this channel. I want you to hit the subscription button so that you don't miss any quality information we release on a daily basis. So hit the subscription button now and hit the like button so that this would show YouTube that this is a very good concept content. Thank you so much. Welcome to Financial Paul channel. Have a great day. Bye-bye.